Unleash the power of multi-masking in Fusion. Let's get right into it. So, I'm already here in Fusion, and I've made a simple text animation. Let's take a look at it. So let me walk you through it real quick. What I've done was I added a background node, a black background. Then I added three text nodes. On my first one, I came to shading. Under properties, here in appearance, I changed it from text fill to text outline. Then my second text, I left it at text fill. And then for my third text node, I came to shading and I enabled the second element, red outline. I changed the color to yellow. And here in properties, I changed it to border fill. And I changed the level to word. And then what I did was I made a mask for each text. So on the first mask, what I did was at frame 12, I started the animation. So I brought it outside of the text. And then in 12 frames, I made it cover the text to make it appear. Then I held it for 12 frames and made the text disappear. In another 12 frames, I kept the soft edge at 0.01. And then by the end of this animation, on my second mask, I started the second animation. So I repeated the process. 12 frames in, hold for 12 frames, and 12 frames out. And the same for the third mask. 12 frames in, hold for 12 frames, and 12 frames out. But what if I told you that you could not go through all the trouble of making three masks and three different animations, and then coming to the spline and smoothing out all the curves individually? So there's a much easier way to make the same effect. So let's disconnect these masks for a while. Let's put it aside. Let's leave our merge nodes and our text nodes. So what we can do is bring one mask, make it the size we want, then come to frame 12, where we start the animation, set a keyframe, bring it outside, then go 12 frames ahead, bring it in, hold for 12 frames, set a keyframe, go another 12 frames ahead, and bring it out. Now we're going to connect the same mask in all of the texts, like this. So how do we make the effect happen? Well, we're going to select our mask, we're going to open our spline, set zoom to fit, select all of the keyframes by hitting Command or Control A on the keyboard, then hitting F on the keyboard to flatten the lines. Now what we can do is we're going to select all of the keyframes again, right click in any of them, then come to Duplicate, Loop, and set the number of loops to 2. What it does is to make our animation happen 3 times. So let's close the spline, and let's see how it looks. See, now to make the text change, what we're going to do is we're going to set the blend mode of merges 2 and 3 to 0, like this. Then, by the end of the first animation, here on the blend of merge 2, we're going to set a keyframe, go one frame ahead, and bring it back to 1. Now, the second animation happens. And when the third animation is about to happen, we do the same thing on merge 3. Set a keyframe, go one frame ahead, set the blend to 1. And now, let's see the animation again. It's the same thing, but you didn't go through all the trouble of making 3 different masks. A lot easier, right? So if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you want to learn more about DaVinci Resolve, check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.